laboratory diagnosis of candidiasis. First one is specimen collection, mucosal patch, skin scraping, nail scraping, sputum, urine and blood samples. So what are the specimen we will collect? Based on site of infection we will collect that sample. Mucosal patches, skin scraping, nail scraping, sputum, urine and blood sample. Then we will do direct microscopy. Gram positive oval budding yeast cell with pseudo hyphae will appear. After specimen collection we will do direct microscopy. Gram positive oval budding yeast cell with pseudo hyphae will occur. Then culturing, two different type of medium we are using, saccharose dextrose agar, DCA and blood agar. In SDA, saccharose dextrose agar, we are adding antibiotic. It will prevent the growth of bacteria. Then we will incubate 37 degrees Celsius. Within 1 to 2 days, colony will appear. It will produce a creamy white and pasty colony. So culturing, we are using SDA, saccharose dextrose agar and blood agar. SDA is the most common medium for fungus. It will produce a creamy white color and pasty colony in 37 degrees Celsius of incubation within 1 to 2 days. Then test us for species identification, germ tube method. This one is positive for Candida albicans. This germ tube method is also called Reynold-Broad phenomenon. These colonies are mixed with the human or sheep serum and incubated for just 2 hours. Wet mount preparation we will do under examination. Germ tube are formed. So laboratory diagnosis of Candida albicans, specimen collection based on site. We will collect that sample. Then we will do microscopy. Gram positive oval budding yeast cell will produce. Then culturing SDA, it will produce a creamy white or pasty colony. Then test for species identification, germ tube method. Germ tube method positive for Candida albicans. Okay, colonies are mixed with human or serum, sheep serum, incubated 2 hours. Wet mount preparation is examined under microscopy. The germ tubes are formed. Then Dalmo plate culture for chlamydospore production on Conmin agar, identified species for Candida albicans. It will produce a thick walled chlamydospore. Dalmo plate culture method, we are using Conmin agar. This one identified Candida albicans. It will produce a thick walled chlamydospores. Then chrome agar, this one is different species of Candida, produced a different color. In chrome agar medium, different species of Candida produced a different color. Example, growth at 45 degrees Celsius positive in the case of Candida albicans, not in Candida doubliensis. So third media, Dalmo plate culture method, we are using Conmin agar. This one is identified Candida albicans. It will produce a thick walled chlamydospore. Then next one is chrome agar. This one different species having different color. Candida albicans will grow 45 degrees Celsius. Candida doubliensis not grow in 45 degrees Celsius. Then sugar assimilation and sugar fermentation test. Different species have different test. Then molecular method such as PCR we are using. Then immunodiagnosis. Antibody detection against the cell wall Mannan antigen. Antigen detection such as cell wall Mannan and cytoplasmic antigen. Enzyme detection, example enolase. Then test for metabolites, example mannitol and arabinitol. So laboratory diagnosis, First one is specimen based on site. We will collect that sample. Then direct microscopy. Then culturing. SDA we are using. Then test for species identification. First test, germ tube test. Within 2 hours in wet mount preparation, it will produce the germ tube in Candida albicans. Then second one is Dalmo plate culture method. Here we are using cornmeal agar. Then chrome agar medium. Then sugar assimilation and sugar fermentation test. Different species having different test. Then molecular method we are using PCR. Then immunodiagnosis, antibody detection against cell wall Mannan antigen, antigen detection such as cell wall Mannan and cytoplasmic antigen, enzyme detection and test for metabolites mannitol and arabinitol. Then treatment, cutaneous candidiasis means we will using topical azole, esophageal and vulvo-vaginal candidiasis means we are using fluconazole. Disseminated candidiasis means we are using amphotericin B. So treatment purpose, cutaneous candidiasis, azole, esophageal and vulvo-vaginal candidiasis means we are using oral fluconazole. Then disseminated candidiasis means we are using amphotericin B. So laboratory diagnosis is very important one. Specimen collection, direct microscopy, culturing, test for species identification. It includes germ tube method, Dalmo plate culture method, chrome agar method, sugar assimilation and sugar fermentation test, then molecular method, immunodiagnosis method, treatment, cutaneous, azole, esophageal and vulvo-vaginal candidiasis means we are using fluconazole. Disseminated candidiasis means we are using amphotericin B.